We have already discussed first and second chapter. Today we will start third chapter, Discovering Tut. The saga continues. So here in the beginning of the lesson, some important highlights it is given. He was just a teenager when he died, the last heir of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was laid to rest laden with gold and eventually forgotten. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated about what happened to him, with murderer being the most extreme possibility, now leaving his tomb for the first time in almost 80 years. Tut has undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death and provides precise data for an accurate forensic reconstruction of the boyish pharaoh. So here in the beginning, the gist of the lesson, what it is given, importance of that highlights, it is given in the beginning of the lesson. Through this we are understanding 4-5 things. So what would be there in the lesson? In title itself, that discovering the Tut, then about the Tut, so how would be the Tut? Especially here, Egyptian mummies, if you will go and just surf about that, you will get the whole picture, the idea about how is the Tut. And we have already discussed about that. You have watched all that videos, documentaries, BBC documentaries, and unwrapping of the Tut. So you have that idea that how would be the situation. And in that, now one more important thing here in the beginning, it is referred. So we will take that highlights of that important things. In that first important highlight, it is he was just a teenager. So here the age group, it is teenager. So any king, if he would be in his teenage and if he would die, certainly there would be some problem or the mystery behind his death. One more important thing here, the last heir of powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries, and he was the last heir or the successor of that Egyptian empire. And here we can understand, yet powerful, the word it is mentioned, powerful family means the legacy of his family, all that powerful things, or the thinking ideology, the way of dealing with all the things, and faith of the citizens, all that things required. But here what is the thing happened, and why here the investigation, all that forensic reconstruction, it is required, that we have to think. He was laid to rest laden with gold, eventually forgotten. And especially royal families, after the death, when especially when they are preparing the funeral, all funerary treasures, then in that, especially with the gold, because they are the royal family members, and in the Valley of the Kings, so you can observe on page number 24, so they have given the map, Valley of Kings, and in that, tomb of Tutankhamun. So here it is, given. So you can Valley of Queens. So everything here in that map it is given. So for the sake of understanding, we can observe that royal family members, they would have a particular place where all their dead bodies with respect and with proper precaution, it will be there. Means now, how is the process? In that process, especially the Egyptians, they are taking more care and it is observed. But one important thing, that is, since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, so here in 1922, that discovery of that Tut, means that young, that teenager, that boy king, young pharaohs, so it was discovered, and the title it is also given, Discovering Tut, the saga continues. Means here, the word saga, so saga refers to what? Means it is prose narrative, especially when dealing with the family or social histories and the legend, and that concern with that legacy or the prose narrative, here it is discussed. One more important thing here it is mentioned, that is, since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated about what happened to him. Means now there is a guess, there is a talk about that, the gossip, all that things now. And there are so many questions in the modern world or the modern people, that what would have happened to that king, the young pharaoh, and with murder being the most extreme possibility. So here murder, there would be the most extreme possibility because the death is at the teenage age. So we can understand here, there are so many things, so many thoughts may come in the modern people and those who are having the faith on them. So their important things here, again it is reflected, what is that? It is mentioned here, now leaving his tomb for the first time in almost 80 years, the Tut has undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death. Means after the discovery in 1922, again more details, means nowadays technology it is upgraded, we have technological tools for the diagnosis, investigations, and we can do more effectively with the help of technology. So here CT scan machine, it is also very useful for the understanding the mystery. And then one more important thing here, provide precise data for an accurate forensic reconstruction. So here forensic reconstruction means the scientific test or the investigation for what? To solve a crime. Means when something would happen and if there is a doubt, you are that death, it is a suspicious death, then we can scientifically investigate that crime and with the help of forensic labs. So in our also India or Maharashtra also, in Pune especially, at forensic lab, in that we can send the report. Means after the death, means in that PM, we will send all that reports, and in that forensic lab they would investigate, and that report has the value. So here we have to think that what had happened in 1922, the reference in detail it is given afterwards. We will go through the lesson in that the beginning passage. An angry wind stirred up ghostly dust devils as King Tut was taken from his resting place in the ancient Egyptian cemetery known as the Valley of the Kings. So here we already discussed that Valley of the Kings. It is given in that map. And where that King Tut, it was rested? It was rested in that Valley of the Kings, and especially the cemetery. The word it is referring to the place is where the tomb of the young pharaoh, it was there. So here an angry wind stirred off. So little bit here, supernatural element it is reflected in the story. And what is that supernatural element? Angry wind stirred off means that angry wind, it was moved off. And why that angry wind it would be here? Because we cannot go and touch the tomb or something. We cannot take the dead body or something from that place. Suddenly something would happen, because there is a faith on such type of things that there would be curse of the pharaoh, or the god would be there to protect and safeguard that body. So all god, goddesses, all things are there. Like that in all religions, such type of legend, such type of things. Still we are also discussing in India also, that whenever there is a place, means funeral place, that place, especially some god, goddesses are there, or there may be the curse of that also person, and it may happen. So here, supernatural element in the beginning itself, then angry wind, stirred of ghostly dust devils, as King Tut was taken from his resting place in the ancient Egyptian cemetery known as the Valley of the Kings. Dark-bellied cloud had scudded across the desert sky all day, and now were veiling the stars of cascade gray. So here, notice these expressions in the text, infer their meaning from the context. So in that year it is given, this scudded across means moved quickly across something. And what is that scudded? The dark-bellied cloud had scudded across a desert sky all day, and now were veiling the stars in cascade gray. So this is the supernatural element due to what? Now they are going to take that the body, dead body of the young pharaoh for the investigation. So all the atmosphere suddenly started changing. Means the dark-bellied clouds also appeared. And one more thing, now the veiling the stars in cascade gray. So here we can understand that the stars also, it is a kind of wrapping on that stars. Means the due to, maybe it is due to the clouds or the atmosphere. That also we can understand. Means here author is trying to convey that this may be the bad omen for others, because now they are trying to take out that dead body from the resting place. And one more important thing here it is mentioned, it was 6 p.m. on 5th January 2005. Means it is the recent update it is given, about the recent update 2005. The world's most famous mummy, glided head first into, means glided means move that head into the CT scanner, brought here to prove lingering medical mysteries of this little understood young ruler. Little understood means because that little, that young pharaoh, he died in the teenage age group. So little understood young ruler who died more than 3,300 years ago. So we can here imagine that only 100 years also, suppose we want the evidence, we may not get that body or something in good condition. But here it is the specialty of the Egyptian funerary system, and especially about the royals. So how they are taking care of such type of the dead bodies of the kings and queens, we can understand, because after 3000 years and 300 years back also, when they would take out that body, the body, the condition and all, means we can observe the things, and especially means if you will surf, you can get that they have taken the DNA also samples through that, and they observed their means the bone of the dead body, means it was hard. So we can understand that the death was, it was in the early age group or the teenage age group. So one more here important thing it is given, that is lingering medical mysteries. And now it is the medical mystery. Why it would be the medical mystery? Because now what they will do, they will take out that all the reports through that CT scanner machine, and afterwards it will be analyzed. All afternoon, the usual line of tourists from around the world had descended into the cramped rock-cut tomb, some 26 feet underground, to pay their respect. And now tourists are there all around the world, because that was the famous thing, famous spot. And the world's, here already it is mentioned, the world's most famous mummy. So their followers, tourists, they would be very curious to know more about that. So here again more explanation it is given, 26 feet underground to pay their respect. And it was not too easy, means it is not easy for any person to take out easily. It is 26 feet down, and there again inside the chambers, different chambers, and in that particular chamber we can observe the mummy of that young pharaoh, the young king. They gazed at the murals on the walls of burial chamber and peered at Tut's gilded face. So here gilded face means it is covered with what, means especially the gold leaf, and using that it can protect the body. So all that things here, and especially royal family, so they have used the gold. The most striking feature of his mummy, shaped out coffin lid. So it means outer part it is of coffin lid. Some visitor read from guidebooks in a whisper. So some they would have already studied the history and more about that king, the young king. So they would whisper. Others stood silently, but and others, those who are new, they don't know about that. Now they are silent. They are silently observing the scene. Perhaps pondering Tut's untimely death. And that was the untimely death. And in that untimely death of his late teens, or wondering with shiver of the, means here, what is the thing would happen if the Pharaoh's curse means now they have taken the decision to take out that dead body, and there may be the curse of that Pharaoh, and what will happen, the death or misfortune falling upon those who disturb him was really true. And was really true means, because now here, the atmosphere suddenly changed. In the beginning itself it is mentioned, an angry wind stayed up, ghostly dust devils. So like that here atmosphere it is there. And one more, dark bellied clouds scudded across the desert all the day, and now we are veiling the stars. So that atmosphere if we are observing, so here they are assuming, what is their assumption? The assumption is that the consistency in understanding, now they are consistently in touch with such type of updates, and especially the tourists, they are more curious about that, but still there is a fear in their mind about the curse of the Pharaoh. And what is that curse? The death or misfortune falling upon those who disturb him. And if someone will disturb the dead body or that the funerary, all that rituals, norms, then something may happen, or the god or someone would be there to protect that, and because of that the curse may come. So like this here, little bit explanation, author created the atmosphere, and afterwards then author started explaining what happened next. The mummy is in very bad condition because of what Carter did in 1920s, said Zahi Hawa, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities, as he leaned over the body for a long first look. Means, because of the earlier investigations, and who had done that earlier investigation? The name it is mentioned here, Carter, Howard Carter, that is, was the British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered that stone after years of futile searching. So here in the beginning also that year it is mentioned, and explanation now we can get it, that what happened in the 1920s. In that 1920s, the Carter discovered that Tut, the Tut of the young Pharaoh. And here one more important thing it is mentioned, discovered Tut's tomb after years of futile. So here futile means incapable of producing any useful result. Means there was no proper result that why the death occurred. Means he was not able to come out with the outcomes of that. But he discovered that Tut, and after in that discovery, what happened? It contains, though hastily ransacked in antiquity. So here ransack means to search through or something thoroughly or often roughly. So here they have done that thing, it is with little bit harsh, so the condition of the body it is not good. So here it is mentioned, the mummy is in very bad condition, the mummy of that young Pharaoh, it was in bad condition. Why the condition happened? Because when here the name is mentioned, that is Carter and Howard Carter, when he discovered that mummy, he had not taken that more care about that. So the condition it is bad. The mummy is in very bad condition because what Carter did in 1920s, said Zahi Hawass, the Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. And now in that discovery, so many things here it is mentioned, and you have already observed in the videos whichever I have shared to you in detail, all things it is also shown in that video. So for more reference you can watch that videos again. And here it is mentioned, were surprisingly complete, ransacked in antiquities, surprisingly complete. They remain the richest royal collection. And that was the richest royal collection. Why it is the royal collection? Because it is of whom? It is of the king or the teenage age group, young pharaoh of that powerful family. So that is the, because of that the word it is mentioned, they remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become part of pharaoh's legend. And now it is the, it becomes the story, the legend of that pharaoh. Stunning artifacts in gold, their eternal brilliance means to guarantee resurrection. So here notice this expression in the text, infer their meaning from the context. In that also resurrection, it is the word it is given, and here it is the new beginning for something which is old. And now after the discovery, again now all that things would be available for others to guess, to think, and so many here tourists, so many people, now they would again get that more information about the young pharaoh. Caused a sensation at the time of the discovery and still get the most attention. And now also it is the most attention. Whenever any person would go, they can think about that. But Tut was also buried with everyday things he would want in the afterlife. In that, board games, bronze razor, linen undergarments, cases of food and wine. So here the day-to-day things also it was there, means funerary rituals, their traditions, as per their traditions, everything it was there in that royal collection. After months of careful recording the pharaoh's funerary treasures, Carter began investigating in his three nested coffins. So here again three nested coffins were there, and in that again more things we can observe. It is given the, you have to prepare the list of the things because question will be asked in that manner. So you should know that what was there in that royal connection, especially it is called a funerary treasures. The word it is treasure. The treasury, especially it is the wealth, and the funerary treasure, it is the royal collection. So here the word it is used, funerary treasures. The Carter began investigating his three nested coffins, opening the first, and in that first, opening the first, he found a shroud adorned with garlands of willow and olive leaves. So here willow and olive leaves, it is there again, wild celery, lotus petals and corn flowers. So this also you keep in mind when question will be asked concerned with the opening the first, means the first nested coffins, and in that year the things whatever it is mentioned you can observe, and especially about the olive leaves, then wild celery, lotus petals. So all that things it was there in that coffins, nested coffins. The faded evidence of burial in March or April. When he finally reached the mummy, though he ran into trouble, and when he finally reached to the mummy, there was again the problem. And what was that problem? The ritual regimes had hardened, cementing Tut to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. And again now here, it is not the easy task to take out that mummy from that, because they have taken more care about that and it was too hard. No amount of legitimate force could move them. The Carter wrote letter, what was to be done, and we cannot take off that easily. Means the no amount of legitimate force could move them. This line, it proves that how they would have taken care of the mummy, because it should not be taken away easily by anyone, because that is the faith. And whenever, means now also, when we are thinking about the king, suppose in Maharashtra, Shivaji Maharaj, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, anything little bit would happen, or if somebody will tell any wrong thing, suddenly as a Maharashtrian, we will give the comment, or we may think that why somebody is saying like this. So we cannot say anything wrong about the such type of kings, queens, those who have given their best contribution to the world, and because their followers are there, and because it is not only the thing of follower, it is their good deed, their contribution, so their respect it is there, and that respect automatically it will create in the next generation also, because that legacy of their thoughts, legacy of their working style, legacy of their contribution and the principles, all things will be carried out in the next generation. So here the sun can beat down like a hammer for this far south in Egypt. The Carter tried to use to lose the resins for several hours. He set the mummy outside in blazing sunshine that heated it to 149 degree Fahrenheit. Nothing budged. Means here the condition it is that he has to take out that things easily. So he set the mummy outside the blazing sunshine. So there was more heat, and he was thinking that now using that thing we can take out that thing, especially here ritual resins, and because in that ritual resins means they have taken care that it will not be taken away easily. So scientifically now he was trying to take out that, sort out that things, but what happened? Nothing blush, nothing moved. He reported with scientific detachment that the consolidated material had to be chiseled away, and now they have to slowly chiseled away with the chisel. Slowly they will do it, because it is not possible directly we can take out that thing beneath the limbs and trunk before it was possible to raise the king's remains. And now the limbs and the trunk, that part, now the beneath that, now they started doing the using that chisel, some slowly at some part of the things it will be taken away. In his defense, the Carter really had little choice. So there was no choice to him like that. Here it is mentioned. If he hadn't cut the mummy free, thieves most certainly would have circumvented the guards. So here, because in that royal collection, all the things it was of the gold, and the thieves, it would be very good opportunity for the thieves that they could take it. And it is not only the matter of the gold, but the mummy of that royal person or the king, it is very important, because if something would happen to that body, if somebody would take out all that things from that place, and if you will not get, it is the matter of national emergency at that time, because suddenly so many people would start thinking about that, they may react and there may be condition of law and order. So here we have to take care. So here it is mentioned that if he hadn't cut the mummy free, thieves most certainly would have circumvented, means circumvented here, found a way avoiding a difficult thing to the guard and rift it apart to remove the gold. And now they have taken care of the mummy and the gold, now it is aside. In Tut's time, the royals were fabulously wealthy. In Tut's time, because it was the Tut of the royal king, the yet young pharaoh, he died in the teenage age group. So here we can mention, what is that? Royals were fabulously wealthy and they thought and hoped they could take their riches with them for his journey to the great beyond. King Tut was lavished with glittering goods. And here now the list it is given. Now I will refer that list for you. Precious collars, inlaid necklace and bracelets. So here inlaid necklace, bracelets and again rings, amulets, then ceremonial apron, sandals, seeds for his fingers and toes, means to protect fingers and toes also, seeds also, it is there. For that understanding, you can see the images of the seeds. And now, iconic inner coffin and mask, all of pure gold, and all that things it is of pure gold. So it is the, it is mentioned here, what they have mentioned about that. In Tut's time, the royals were fabulously wealthy. The fabulously wealthy means here, all things it is of the gold. Then one more here. To separate Tut from his adornment, Carter's men removed the mummy's head and served neatly every major joint. Once they had finished, they reassembled the remains on a layer of sand and wooden box with padding that concealed the damage, the bed where the Tut was rest. So now Carter's men, they have taken care of all that things, and with the chisels, and here we can understand that he had taken care of the body also, but the condition of the mummy, it was not at all good, because it was the ransacked, means little bit rough way Carter had done that investigation. And then here some references given. Archaeology had changed substantially in the investigating decades. So here, day by day, due to technological changes, we can observe that there are more things, more updates we can get, or more precise information we can get about any crime in that forensic lab. Means we can use the modern tools. So here, what is that mentioned here? Focusing less on the treasure and more on the fascinating details of life, intriguing mysteries of death. Now here we have to think about the, what was the mystery of death, why death happened. So here more things, it also uses more sophisticated tools, and now more sophisticated tools, more here technological updates, and in that technological update, including medical technology. And in that medical technology, now here author is focusing in 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery. Means Carter's discovery, it is in 1922, and after that year, 40 years, in 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy and revealed the startling fact. So in that x-ray, what he observed, and that observation, it is beneath the resin that cracked his chest, and his breastbone and front ribs are missing. And that anatomy professor observed, and what is that important thing here in that observation, in that x-ray observation, using that sophisticated tool, that is his beneath the resin that cracked his chest, his breastbone and front ribs are missing. And that is the finding of that x-ray. And who had done that? An anatomy professor had discovered that. Today, diagnostic imaging can be done with computed tomography or CT, means CT scan machine. So using that CT scan machine, we can get the more virtual picture of that. Means x-ray has some limitations, but in CT scan machine, again more details with proper way we can observe, by which hundreds of x-rays in cross section are put together like slices of bed and create three-dimensional virtual body. So in x-ray, that three-dimensional virtual body we cannot observe, but there is facility in the CT scan, where more sophisticated tool than the x-ray, it is CT scan machine. What more would a CT scan reveal of that than the x-ray, and could it answer to the biggest question till lingering about him? Still that question, it is there in so many people's mind. And what is that question? The question is, how did he die, and how old was he at the time of his death? So two important questions here, it is there in everyone's mind, and that is, how did he die? What was the reason of his death? And how old was he at the time of his death? And his age. So two questions are there, and author is focusing on that two questions. And further now, the family, family history, and then CT scanner machines, all details are given. So we will discuss all that details in the next video.